What's up, guys? Devin here from American Aquarium. The question being asked is, what's the best sterilizer for the price? If you're not sure if a sterilizer is needed, definitely take a look at the resources below for in-depth information as to why. Yes, very much so, a sterilizer is needed. First, you gotta ask yourself if the UV sterilizer is actually a UV sterilizer and not just a clarifier. A true sterilizer will have disease, bacterial, parasite up to viral control, and also aid in osmotic stress for the fish. This is known as redox balance. Most sterilizers on the market will be called a sterilizer when in fact they can only achieve clarification, no disease prevention actually. The way this can be done with a true sterilizer is the length of the lamp, including the distance between the lamp in the chamber to the outer chamber wall. If it's a narrower chamber, there's going to be a closer contact to the lamp, meaning more sterilization UVC is getting to the water. If there's a wider chamber, say like in a canister filter, where you have a short lamp with a huge chamber, that light is not as intense to the outside of the chamber, so therefore it's less able to do real sterilization. The lamp type also plays into how well it could sterilize. This also goes to the distance from the lamp to the outer wall. A T5 is a narrower lamp, therefore it's going to have a larger gap between the lamp and the outer wall. A T8, while a T5 may be more efficient, a T8 will be wider, therefore a narrower chamber, so as water passes over the lamp, it is closer to the lamp. There's also the difference between a medium pressured lamp and a low pressure lamp. Medium pressure are more commonly used in nail curing and have a UVC output of about 7%. A low pressured UV lamp is a quality, high output, 35% high output UV lamp, which is used in premium sterilizers. That's a big difference in the amount of sterilization, 5 times the amount. Another factor is turbidity. This is how the water enters the sterilizer and is being passed by the lamp and exiting. If there's bevels or swivels, which are actually marketed as something that's better because it's supposed to spin the water all the way around the lamp, actually they're claiming that it'll have a longer contact time with the water on the lamp, are and have been tested to be gimmicks, so there's a higher turbidity. This also goes to pre-filtration, how the water is going through the lamp, if it's pre-filtered and getting the larger particulates out before the water enters the UV sterilizer, makes for much more sterilized water. Here's a quote from our sterilization article written by the founder of American Aquarium with all the experience. He writes, "If turbidity is high and biofiltration is low, it will require double the amount of UVC to achieve the same results." There's other things that can go into how well a sterilizer clarifier can work. It could be temperature of the water, and also the manufacturer's rating of how much flow should be going past the lamp at a given time, gallons per hour. AAP has their own calculations on flow based on real-world designs, given if the sterilizer is a premium to an economy-type sterilizer. We have a graph in the article below that will tell you exactly how much flow, based on experience, is needed to achieve clarification up to true sterilization. Some clarity definition here as well. There can be clarification or sterilization level 1, that's bacterial parasite control, or level 2, which is up to virus control. These sterilizers also can be rated on an A, B, C scale, where an A sterilizer will be able to do up to virus control. A B sterilizer most of the time can do level 1 sterilization, but depending might be able to do level 2, that could be based on gallons per hour and flow and how many watts you're using. And then level C is usually just a clarifier and cannot achieve sterilization. This same rating A, B, and C can also be applied to the construction of the sterilizer, with C being usually economy, more on the poor side. If you get 2 years of life out of that type of clarifier, you're actually doing really good. B is a little better economy, and C would be a more premium sterilizer. Of the last decade or so, or even just the last 5 years, the market is being flooded by a lot of Category C clarifiers that are marketed as sterilizers, and you cannot get sterilization with these. So for the best sterilizers, this is going to be Emperor, Aqua, and the AAP Vecton and Advantage line. There's a whole history of how we came to find what the best sterilizers are. We actually have some publication about those real world experiments and how the founder of American Aquarium found what was actually truly sterilizers. There might be a couple other UV sterilizers that would be a category A out there, but they're not marketed for the aquarium industry. So these principles that we talked about earlier can be applied to determine if it's a category A, B, or C. So to answer the question, what's the best sterilizer out for the price? American Aquarium is going to say that it's the AAP Vecton and Advantage line, giving true level 1 and level 2 sterilization for the best dollar value. And again, there's other brands out there that will give this level 1, level 2 sterilization, but it'll be at nearly double the cost. These sterilizers come out of the UK and have a solid build and have very little failure rates for the equipment. And a huge plus is the parts are readily available and usually about half the cost as other brands as well. So we're actually going to go out on a limb and say that the best sterilizer hands down, not even just for the price, are these Vecton and Advantage lines. This is based on real world experience, using and selling hundreds of units, and seeing how applying the sterilizer with different variables makes it hands down the best. And we can also say this because the founder of American Aquarium, Carl Strohmeyer, has used all of the brands and has been able to apply the sciences and see the real results. I want you guys to know I appreciate you viewing our videos. Thank you for taking a look at our written articles. Thank you for supporting us at American Aquarium Products. I look forward to talking to you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye.